Good morning. Thank you and welcome everyone. Beautiful day. Not too cold. This is the fourth week in Advent. If you'd looking for some wonderful Christmas music, Christmas concert, you can check out our parish website, and on the front page, La Noche Azul. We had our annual Advent Christmas gathering, but it's online, virtual, and we've already had over 500 hits on it, and it's 45 minutes of beautiful Christmas music to get you in the spirit of the season. Check it out if you haven't seen it. And today, with the second reading, Paul puts in effect a toast to God for everything God has done through Jesus Christ, the gift of salvation. And if you were to give a toast to God, here's to you, God, for all you've done for me, what would be the highlights of your life that you would include in that toast? You did this, here's to you. God, thank you. And what a place, great place to thank God, but here at this Mass today, we thank and praise God for the great things God has done in our lives, just like Mary did in her Magnificat. Take a moment of quiet, and then we will begin with song and welcome Treble Cantori to help us worship well. Thanks for coming.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. This is the fourth week of Advent. We pray a blessing on the Advent wreath. The first week, we focused on the candle of peace. The second week, the candle of hope. The third week, the candle of joy. And this week, as we recall the fire in the belly of John the Baptist and the courage of Mary to be the mother of God, the young teenager that she was, and the faithfulness of Joseph, who accompanied her on the way, we light the candle of love. Lord, bless this Advent wreath. May its light shine forth, be a light for us on our way. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to save sinners. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to heal the sick. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. So let us pray. Lord, fill our hearts with love as you revealed to us by the angel the coming of your Son. And so lead us through his suffering and death to the glory of the resurrection. For he lives and reigns with you, the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Our virtual huddle time for little ones and all here. The story today is an interesting one. A young teenage girl is confused. An angel appears to her with news that she has a hard time believing, and quite frankly, I don't blame her. But in the end, she trusts God, and good things happen. And so, if you listen real closely to this reading, you're going to hear who that young teenage girl was, and the wonderful thing that happened when she trusted God. Let's pray. Lord, bless these little ones, all of us here today as we hear your holy word. Pray for Christ our Lord.
Reading from the second book of Samuel. When King David was settled in his palace, and the Lord had given him rest from his enemies on every side, he said to Nathan the prophet, "Here I am living in a house of cedar, while the ark of God dwells in a tent." Nathan answered the king, "Go, do whatever you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that night, the Lord spoke to Nathan and said, "Go tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, should you build me a house to dwell in? It was I who took you from the pasture and from the care of the flock to be commander of my people, Israel. I have been with you wherever you went, and I have destroyed all your enemies before you. And I will make famous like the great ones of the earth. I will fix a place for my people, Israel. I will plant them so that they may dwell in their place without further disturbance. Neither shall the wicked continue to afflict them as they did of old, since the time I first appointed judges over my people, Israel. I will give you rest from all your enemies. The Lord also reveals to you that he will establish a house for you. And when your time comes and you rest with your ancestors, I will raise up your heir after you, sprung from your loins, and I will make his kingdom firm. I will be a father to him, and he shall be a son to me. Your house and your kingdom shall endure forever before me. Your throne shall stand firm forever. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, to him who can strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery kept secret for long ages, but now manifested through the prophetic writings and according to the command of the eternal God, made known to all nations to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory to forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Oh, The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what was said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said unto her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age. And this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done unto me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord. Christmas time is here, happiness and cheer, snowflakes in the air, COVID everywhere. If Charlie Brown ever had a reason for feeling melancholy at Christmas, this year would be it. The same is true for Linus, ever clinging to his security blanket. Nothing is normal for Christmas 2020. Holiday parties? Not allowed. Merry Christmas greetings? Muffled by masks. Shopping at the mall or sharing a cup of Christmas cheer? Not if you value your health. And besides, the restaurants and the bars are closed anyway. Christmas carols. Not this year. Singing is especially dangerous. And particularly hard to bear is the absence of families gathering together for the holiday, in many cases, despite their prolonged separation throughout this long year. Our minds and our hearts tell us that the sacrifices that we are making during this pandemic are necessary to protect the most vulnerable. And in many cases, that's true. But the loss we feel is real, and it's understandable that it may leave us feeling anxious and even sad during what we know should be a season of joyful expectation. And if that's true for the fortunate among us who still have jobs, who still have food on our tables, who still have a roof over our head, if that's true for the fortunate among us who have not lost a loved one this year, then perhaps we can begin to imagine the pain and the distress of those who have not been so fortunate. I grew up watching a Charlie Brown Christmas every year, like most people in my generation. There's a quiet and warm peacefulness about it. In fact, CBS studio executives nearly pulled the plug on it at the last minute because it was too peaceful. As a matter of fact, they thought it was too depressing for us holiday special, at least. That and CBS panicked over the inclusion of the gospel reading from Luke. They say that if CBS had not already promoted the special in the TV guide for that week, they would have pulled the plug. But as it is, Charlie Brown Christmas was wildly popular and became an enduring Christmas must-see classic, I think because of its perceived flaws. The climactic scene is Linus's proclamation of the good news from Luke's gospel to answer Charlie Brown's discouragement and bewilderment about the true meaning of Christmas. God's gift of our Savior, Jesus, was born in a stable, laid in a manger, and attended by poor, humble shepherds. In today's gospel, we read an earlier passage from Luke that I believe also speaks to our jumble of feelings during this Advent season. The angel Gabriel appears to a very bewildered Mary to deliver an incredible message that she, a poor virgin teenager, would bear a child, the Son of God. Mary was no dummy. She knew this would be difficult. She knew it might mean scandal or worse. After all, who would believe her story that God got her pregnant? Would Joseph abandon her? Would her parents kick her out? Would the neighbors scorn her or stone her for adultery? Who then could blame her if the good news might have been muted by anxiety, melancholy, or fear? But the good news is that her faith was stronger than her fear. And so she said, "Yes, may it be done unto me according to your word." She did what she could, and she trusted God to do the rest. And when it comes right down to it, isn't that our invitation as well? This year, every year, to do our best in faith and in love and let God do the rest. So what can we do this year in the days that remain to prepare for the coming of Jesus? Our first reading, I think, gives us a clue. King David, who was a former poor shepherd boy, was motivated by gratitude, grateful for his new splendid cedar house, okay, palace. David wanted to build a house for God. But God had a better idea. God didn't really need a house. But what he wanted to do instead was to establish a house for David forever. And not only for David, but for the whole of the family of God. That same house is the house and family that Jesus was born into. That same house and family is the house and the family that we have been born into as well now. And now we are its heirs. That eternal house. Now that is something to be truly grateful for. And the thing about gratitude, just like love, is that it wants to be given away. And when you give it away, it multiplies. And it grows. Charlie Brown found the true meaning of Christmas after he stepped out of his melancholy and did something nice for others. What Lucy called involvement. That opportunity is ours as well, if we want it. And the possibilities are nearly as numerous as the angels singing glory to God in the highest. Those of you who have contributed household items for Trinity Mission this week have found one way to express your gratitude and to embrace the joy of Christmas. Our new Lazarus Table Endowment Fund is another way. Lazarus Table was inspired by gratitude and by the desire by its generous founding donors to help those who find themselves in dire economic need, find themselves struggling financially, especially during this very difficult year. So many in our midst have lost their jobs. So many cannot keep up with their mortgage, pay their rent. So many cannot afford Christmas presents because they're struggling to put food on the table. If your gratitude for home, hearth, and health so moves you, then I hope that you will contribute or consider contributing also to this worthy endeavor. Your gift will surely change somebody's life for the better, maybe even yours. And for those who have nowhere else to turn in their darkness, this lifeline will shine like a light. In the gospel, despite her bewilderment, Mary showed us the meaning of faith, doing what she could and trusting God to do the rest. And as a result, there was no greater joy that first Christmas morning than Mary's. In the waning dark days of this Advent season, as Christ draws near, let's do the same. Do what we can. Trust God to do the rest. And rediscover the Christmas joy that's always there for us.
Our profession of faith. I believe
in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a life of the world to come. Amen.
Amen. This fourth week of Advent, as we prepare for Christmas, we offer these prayers for our world and for the needs here.
For those in the church who may feel alienated for whatever reason, that they may believe that they are always welcome and that we may extend an inviting hand to them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For lawyers and judges and all others who work in the legal system, that they may always serve with honor, without prejudice, and in ways that bring justice to all. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, the suffering, and the dying, especially those in nursing homes who have been forgotten by others, that they may experience the loving hand of the Lord through the outreach of others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters with whom we share the Christian journey, those who are in our neighborhoods, our places of work, and in our local community, that they may be blessed and that they may receive the consolation of God's presence in their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are estranged from family and friends, that reconciliation may be found and that a spirit of joy may return to their lives. We pray to the Lord.
We pray for Bill Smith, a friend of the St. Victoria Parish family who died this past week. We keep others in our prayers as we turn to you. Loving God, as Christmas draws near, open our hearts to the joy of this season, to the hope of this season, and the love that is here in this season. When we reach out and multiply that love, and live in gratitude all the more. With all this in mind, we ask these prayers for us, not just those here, but for our world this day. We pray through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. This Christmas coming up, we've got a number of things going on. We'll tell you about our annual Building Bridges event. It's in the past, been a breakfast, in person, a speaker. This year, virtual, online, like a lot of things. And it features a former NFL MVP and a baseball Hall of Fame player. And I'm talking about Rich Gannon, who will interview Paul Molitor, and that will be virtual. So the whole family can sit in, and that is coming up January 2nd, Saturday morning is our typical time for that, Saturday at 9 a.m. And to be able to get the link to this, to dial in, you need to register online. Like a lot of these events, we kind of leverage it with let's do something good for the community. So your donation would go to the local food shelves, which is really needed at this time. So that's coming up. We're very excited about that. A virtual experience, so the whole family can tune in Saturday, January 2nd. More on that next week. Also, now we've got Christmas coming up with our Christmas mass schedule, confessions, Tuesday night, Thursday, starting early and going throughout the day. That is Christmas Eve, by the way. We will have a number of masses, a total of 8, to kind of spread the crowd around, make room for everybody. The first two, as there's an indoor mass, there will be an outdoor mass, the first two. And I'll tell you that it's probably the earliest mass in Carver County, if not the 7-county metro area, thanks to Bishop Hebda gave a special permission to start early and accommodate the crowds. Check the bulletin for the time on that early mass and all the masses for your convenience. That's what's coming up. As we talk about the masses and 8 of them, desperately need liturgical ministers. Maybe that is a good word. That is Eucharistic ministers and greeter ushers, even a couple of sacristans. If you've never done it, no problem. Report early, we'll train you in, and it'll be a one-time opportunity for you. But if you find you like it, you can stick around for and be on the team of liturgical ministers for whatever ministry you want.
So that you can sign up on online with Sign Up Genius, it is called. That'd be great. If you've never done it, no problem. Put your name in. We'd love to have you help out. What a great way to give back. And Deacon Ray talking about, you know, like love, gratitude begs to be given away, and the more you give it away, the more you have of it. What a beautiful way to do that with Trinity Mission. Last call, 1 o'clock, bring your blankets and socks and laundry soap, all this, to the Commons. We'll take it, and Sarah Svenby will deliver that down to Trinity Mission and others. That'll mean a lot. Lazarus Table, more on that coming up, another way to give back. And for now, kind of the thought for the day, you may be just one person in the world, but to one person you can be the world. Quote from Mary Jo Copeland, that is true. Be the world for that one person you reach out to. Let's gather the gift of our lives now and come to the altar and celebrate Eucharist together in the spirit of love, faith, hope, and love. Thank you. Sisters and brothers, pray that gifts of bread and wine be pleasing and acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Lord, may the power of the Spirit, which sanctified Mary, the Mother of God, so make holy the gifts we place upon this altar. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, we do well always and everywhere to give you thanks through Jesus Christ. His future coming was proclaimed by all the prophets. The Virgin Mother bore him in her womb with a love that was beyond all telling. John the Baptist was his herald, made him known when at last he came. In his love, Christ has filled us with joy as we prepare to celebrate his birth, so that when he comes, he may find us watching in prayer, our hearts filled with wonder and praise. And so with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your glory and join in their unending hymn of praise.
Holy, 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 God of hosts.
seated. Holy indeed, O Lord, and all creation rightly gives you praise through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit. You give life to all things and make them holy. Never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to the glory of your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night before he died, Jesus took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate his saving passion, his glorious and wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile the world to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may receive an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, together with Francis, our Holy Father, Bernard, our bishop, Andrew, his associate, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people your Son has gained for your own. Father, hear the prayers of the family you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. For it is through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, that all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from all that is evil. Grant us peace in our day. With the help of the mercy, free us from sin. Keep us safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, "My peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit. Let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Peace, everyone. God, he who takes away the sin of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be. Those participating in this Mass through live stream, we offer this prayer of spiritual communion.
Lord Jesus, you are present in the gift of your body and blood, which we celebrate in Eucharist. Since at this moment we are not physically present at your altar to receive you sacramentally, we open our hearts to you as we receive you spiritually. As we embrace you with our love, you embrace us with your love. And so now, in holy communion with you and one another, as the united body of Christ, we ask this prayer in your holy name. Amen.
In anticipation of the communion we share, we pray, Lord, in this sacrament, we receive the promise of salvation. And so we pray, as Christmas draws near, make us grow in faith and love to celebrate the coming of Christ our Savior, who is Lord forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. May we now be blessed as we share this gift. I pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace and gratitude. We share the gift of Jesus Christ.